Return of the Jedi. Oh, there's something else I'd like to explain. Very often when a film is in production, it has what's known as a working title. Revenge of the Jedi was the working title. The original title was Return of the Jedi. The film company went back to the original. Now, let's roll the trailer for Return of the Jedi.
The battle between good and evil rages on. Join the further adventures of Luke Skywalker, Han Solo, Princess Leia, Lando Calrissian, Chewbacca, C-3PO and R2-D2, and Darth Vader. A journey to alien worlds.
It's a trap!
A rebellion against oppression. An epic of heroes and villains. An adventure as vast as the universe.
Right now, we're going to look at some footage having to do with designing the new creatures and aliens from the third episode of the Star Wars saga. Let's return to the Return of the Jedi.
In March 1982, location shooting began within the vast desert landscape of Buttercup Valley, California, for Revenge of the Jedi, the third episode of the Star Wars saga. The 212-foot-long, 80-foot-high set, one of the biggest ever built for a motion picture, took 110 men 4 months to construct. George Lucas, creator and executive producer, assembled a team of film craftsmen, led by British director Richard Marquand, to bring his story and its complex action and special effects sequences to the screen, and producer Howard Kazanjian, whose wide range of responsibilities included establishing the Jedi Creature Department under the leadership of special effects and stop-motion animator Phil Tippett, whose task was the creation of what was to become the largest collection of creatures and aliens ever assembled for a film.
A curious thing about this shop is that we really have not had a lot of experience doing this kind of work.
We built the crew up primarily of people that had worked at ILM in the effects facility. We hired model makers and sculptors, people that could do the machine work to achieve the articulation. And then we hired other local people that had experience in building and fabricating costumes. We usually don't hire people without professional experience, but a 19-year-old kid who had quite a few talents that he picked up and taught himself in school became a very valuable asset and member of the team.
Okay, now ease off. Okay, back it up, okay?
Ready?
Okay. When we first started doing design work on Jedi, we just started making monsters, just weird and horrible monsters. While designing a lot of the work, we really tried to depart as far as we could from what you've seen before.
We were thinking of things that would look weird, different compilations of animal forms stuck together and rearranged.
It's called a lot of little busts and plasticine clay. And from those, George would choose those that he liked or say he wanted some changes. Based on those, we would decide how big a creature would be, what kind of articulation it would have, and start working out the possible relationships of size to other people. The Gamorrean guards, who we ended up calling the pig guards, required a great deal of articulation, and in order to accomplish this, we had to do a lot of extensive testing and design work to enable us to get the kind of animalistic grimaces that we were looking for.
This is the skull that fits inside the pig guard's mask.
and as you can see, involves a lot of springs, a lot of wires, a lot of hinges. The eyebrows are just things that work like normal eyebrows. Muscles connected to skin. And the snoot actually has little plastic nostrils, sort of like we have cartilage. So what will happen is that there will be the actor inside this mask, and then there'll be two or three other guys standing around and working these handles so that the actor can concentrate on his gross body gestures and the individual can concentrate on all the little actions.
Can you see? Can we let him see in the mirror what's going on?
Yes.
If you can, walk forward, thinking always that, you're a real heavy monster, pointing the toe, bringing it forward, squashing, lifting the leg up, pointing the toe, bringing it over, squashing. You may have to exaggerate your movements a little bit more. Just like really, really a heavy, beefy thing, 500 pounds. Just walk a little bit more freely. That's looking very, very good. That looks great.
Those costumes don't just happen by accident. Each individual person has to have their feet, arms, legs, bodies, and heads fitted. And then, when the heads go on, they can barely see, they can barely breathe, they have an enormous lot of energetic acting to do. And you have to be aware while you're playing the scene that the person inside is probably at the point of suffocation just at the moment when you want that extra something from them.
Red light, let's go. Settle down, please. Thank you. Stand by.
Return of the Jedi is the third episode of the middle trilogy. In other words, George Lucas sees this epic adventure as three trilogies, three sets of three films each, or nine episodes that will span 40 years. We'd like to thank Lucasfilm for letting us have that terrific footage.